See, if you are looking toward the anatomy of ovary, I have told you that ovary is oval structure and it is having a small stalk. Now, when we are cutting the longitudinal section of this ovary, so internally we can see the different zones which are getting appear. So first of all, the outermost protective covering. Each ovary is covered by or protected by a protective layer. Protective layer, which is called as tunica albuginea, and this tunica albuginea is exactly similar to the testis tunica albuginea, and it is made up of dense irregular tissue. Okay, so it is made up of dense irregular tissue, or you can say dense irregular connective tissue, which is rich in collagen fiber. Okay, now just below this, this blue line you can see, this blue line is nothing but germinal epithelium. Okay, so germinal epithelium you can see, and this germinal epithelium, according to the epithelial tissue, is actually cuboidal. Cuboidal epithelium. So this is cuboidal epithelium, you can see. Okay, now the inner portion just below this germinal epithelium, the innermost part, or all the part you can say, so all the inner part are actually filled by a kind of loose connective tissue, and that tissue is called as stromal tissue here. Okay, and that stromal tissue is divided into two zones. You can see I have marked by this dotted boundary. So this inner zone, this is inner zone is called as medulla. Inner zone is called medulla, and this is outer zone, and this outer zone is called cortex. So actually inside ovary, the total area is divided into two zones. Outer zone is cortex and inner zone is medulla. The inner zone basically have what? If you will see, the inner zone basically have blood vessels plus nerves. Okay, so inner zone is having blood vessels and nerves, and the point from where these blood vessels are getting entry, so this entry point of blood vessel and nerves is called as hilum or hilus. So hilum or hilus is what? This is the point of entry of blood vessel and nerves into the ovary. Okay, now the developmental part which is happening into the ovary is actually happening into the cortex zone, that is outer zone. You can see all the ovarian follicles are getting developed into the cortex part. So cortex part is therefore very, very important, and it shows the successive stages of development of different ovarian follicles. So actually many ovarian follicles are developing together, but we cannot draw all together, so we used to represent only development of one follicle. Okay, but remember that the same thing is happening with the other follicles which are under the process of development. So there is first stage, which is primordial. Some of the very minute follicle you will see, which are called as primordial follicles. Primordial follicles means just few of the germinal epithelium cells are getting aggregated and making a small aggregate or clump of the cell, which is called a primordial follicle. Now, inside this primordial follicle, the oogenesis will start, that is the development of female gamete egg. Okay, so that process is called oogenesis. So oogenesis will take place inside this, and one of the cell is going to be differentiated, and then it will going to convert it into the primary follicle. So this one, another stage is what? Primary follicle. Okay, so primary follicle you can see. Now this primary follicle will further develop into secondary follicle. So I am writing secondary like this. Okay, secondary follicle. And once secondary follicle is going to be developed, it will converted into tertiary follicle. Tertiary follicle. Okay. Tertiary follicle. And when tertiary follicle is getting mature, then we will get a mature follicle, and that mature follicle is called Graafian follicle. So remember, mature ovarian follicles are called Graafian follicle. Now this Graafian follicle will undergo the process of ovulation, means this Graafian follicle will rupture due to high concentration of luteinizing hormone, that is LH hormone, in the mid period of menstrual cycle, and then this follicle is going to be ruptured and release this secondary oocyte out with some follicular cells. Okay, so this clump of cell is considered as egg or ovum, but it is not actual egg, okay, because it is secondary oocyte. Okay, some of the developmental development is still left, so that is why it is not the real egg. Real egg will be formed once the sperm will penetrate and activate the egg, then the remaining developmental process will complete, and then it is turning into the complete egg. Okay, so this is the secondary oocyte only, so which is coming out during the ovulation process, and rest of the cells of Graafian follicle which are left behind are going to be mixed and making another structure which is yellow in color, and hence it is called as yellow spot, and hence it is called as yellow spot, and technically it is called as carpus luteum. Luteum means yellow, carpus means body, so that is why it is called as yellow spot. So ruptured Graafian follicle will generate another structure, carpus luteum, which is one of the endocrine structure and release different types of hormones. So the main hormone which is related from the carpus luteum is actually progesterone, and besides progesterone, it is also releasing a small amount of estrogen, relaxin. Okay, so these hormones are getting released from here, and its lifetime after formation is almost 7 to 10 days. Then it is going to be degenerated if fertilization is not happening. Okay, so there are two cases. Suppose the egg which has come out after the ovulation is getting fertilized by the sperm, then during the embryonic development this carpus luteum is required, that is why due to hormonal changes after the fertilization, this yellow spot or carpus luteum is going to be rescued. Okay, and it is not going to be degenerated. But if fertilization has not happened, then what is happening actually, this carpus luteum after completing its life of 7 to 10 days going to be degenerated, because there is no use of this, okay, due to absence of fertilization event. Okay, so it is going to be degenerated, and when it is going to be degenerated, it will become white in color and going to be shrink. So since it is white in color, hence it is called as carpus albicans. Albicans, alba. Alba means white, carpus means body. So it becomes white body, and then it is going to be degenerated. Okay, so remember, carpus albicans is nothing but destroyed form of carpus luteum. So in this way, different follicles are going to be developed into the ovary, and this process is repeating during the each month of menstrual cycle. And remember one thing, I have told you that many follicles are going to be developed together, but only one follicle will ovulate. Remaining, which are not going to be developed into the Graafian follicle and little bit behind, all these follicles are going to be degenerated automatically. Okay, so they will not rest. Okay, and you can think like that, that remaining follicles which are under the process of development, but they are not attaining the Graafian follicular stage, so they will not survive for the next cycle. They are automatically going to be degenerated, and new primary follicle will start development into the new month of menstrual cycle or female reproductive cycle. Okay, so in this way, each month one ovulation is happening from the one ovary, and since there are two ovary in a female, one is left, one is right, so it is going to be in alternate fashion generally. Okay, it is going to be in alternate fashion generally. Once time it is from the right ovary, then in the next time it is from the left ovary. Okay, so this is the detailed structure of the ovarian anatomy.